Hello and welcome. Let's prove a very interesting integral result. If you look up any table of integrals, you'll find that the integral of 1 over a squared plus x squared with respect to x is equal to 1 over a times the arctangent of x divided by a, or the inverse tan of x divided by a, plus c, an integration constant, provided that a is not equal to 0. Now, if a was equal to 0, it would simply end up with the integral of 1 over x squared, which is equal to x to the power of negative 2, and we can simply use the integral power formula to find the result, so it would be rather straightforward. But because we've got an a squared term in there, it's very interesting how we start with an expression that's algebraic, and once we integrate it, we end up with a result that's trigonometric. So how do we get there? Well, because we have this annoying a squared term in there, I know I'm going to have to make a substitution to find this integral. So why don't we try substituting u for a squared plus x squared? So in other words, let u is equal to a squared plus x squared, and then if I differentiate u with respect to x, I'll end up with differentiation of a squared as a constant goes to 0, and differentiation of x squared is equal to 2x. So that would imply then our expression for dx is equal to du divided by 2x, just a simple rearrangement of this expression. So now let's substitute in these terms. So 1 over a squared plus x squared dx, I'm going to say, is equal to the integral of 1 over u du on 2x, and tidying up a little bit, I'll get half outside of 1 divided by ux du. Now, can I integrate that? And the answer is no, because this x here cannot be taken outside of the integral because it is a dependent variable, because u depends on the value of x. So I can't say this, 1 on 2x, 1 over u du. So I can't treat x as a constant. So in this case, a simple u substitution won't work. So how do we get around that? Well, here's where Pythagoras theorem and trigonometry comes to help. If I draw myself a right angle triangle, if I label the longer of the shorter side a and the shorter of the shorter sides x, and I square these terms, a squared and x squared, then I know the relationship between the hypotenuse, the longer side, and the two shorter sides is a squared plus x squared. So that's Pythagoras' theorem. And then from trigonometry, I can find an expression for the angle between the hypotenuse and the length a. So from trigonometry, tan theta is equal to the opposite side, x, on the adjacent side, a. So knowing that, we can say then that theta is equal to the inverse tan of x on a. And equally, I can say that x is equal to a tan theta. And as x is a tan theta, if I differentiate x with respect to theta, I'll get dx d theta is equal to a, the constant remains, and tan differentiates to sec squared theta, so then I can write dx now as a sec squared theta d theta. So these are the two substitutions we're going to have to make in order to solve this integral. So let's do that. So the integral of 1 over a squared plus x squared dx is equal to 1 over a squared plus a tan x, sorry, a tan theta all squared multiplied by a sec squared theta. Theta. Alright, now tidying up a little bit. Well, the bottom expression, if I expand the squared in there, means I can factor out an a squared, 1 plus tan theta, tan squared theta I should say, in brackets. At the top I'll just copy down a squared, a sec squared theta, d theta. A and an a squared will cancel out, and I'll bring it out the front. 1 over times the integral of sec squared theta over 1 plus tan squared theta to theta. Okay, well, here's a good trick. This 1 plus tan squared theta from trigonometric identities is equal to sec squared theta. So we can rewrite as 1 over a times integral of sec squared theta divided by sec squared theta to theta, and these will cancel out to be equal to 1. So we'll end up with 1 over a times the integral of 1 d theta, which of course equals 1 over a theta plus some integration constant. But theta we expressed before as the inverse tan of x on a. So let's put that back in. And I like to write more neatly, 1 on a arctan theta as arctan. So 1 on a times the arctan of x on a plus an integration constant. So there you have it. This is how you would get this mysterious result from the integral of 1 over a squared plus x squared. This is the first in a line of videos that I will do on integrals using trigonometric substitutions, so stay tuned for the upcoming videos. If you have found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up. If you are a math student, please feel free to subscribe for future videos that may help you on assignments or exams. If you have any question that you would like me to do a video on, please feel free to comment on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you learned something.